Arizona State Museum is approaching its 125th anniversary, and our community, our friends, our students, colleagues across campus know the Arizona State Museum as the oldest and largest anthropology museum in the Southwest. But at least since the mid-1970s, there has been an historical and ethno-historical dimensioning component that is part of the larger mission of the Arizona State Museum, which is to promote a greater understanding of the peoples and cultures of the Southwest and Northern Mexico. So I want to talk about national impact as a historian here at the State Museum. I would definitely go back and talk about Father Charles Polzer, a Jesuit priest and also an ethno-historian, who founded the DRSW, the Documentary Relations of the Southwest, in 1975, or the exact date is always up to sort of subject to debate, but the mid-1970s. And it was Father Polzer's dream to establish a New World Archive here in the Southwest. And by New World Archive, he wanted to identify and obtain documents detailing Spain's presence in what we now call the Southwest and Northern Mexico. So going to archives in Spain, Italy, Mexico, and other parts of the United States like the Bancroft Library at UC Berkeley or in Washington, D.C., he identified any and all documents that addressed Spain's presence in the Southwest. Over time, those documents, mostly microfilm, although not all, mostly microfilm, take up about 1,200 reels of microfilm that are located on the third floor of the Arizona State Museum in the Office of Ethnohistorical Research. What's interesting about the DRSW, again, that's the acronym, Documentary Relations of the Southwest, is that it consists of about 17,000 document clusters that are part of an online master index that is available to the general public, to our students, and to researchers, well, around the world, actually. They have access to the online master index. Those 17,000 document clusters, a cluster can be a one-page document or many-page document. If we were to print out those 17,000 document clusters, we're looking at well over 500,000 sheets of historical documentation. So it's quite impressive. And what those documents do, I mean, Spain's presence is sort of a broad umbrella. On a more detailed level, they let us know about the civil, military, religious, and ecological contexts to the Spanish Empire in places like our own backyard, Arizona, New Mexico, California, Texas, and our neighbors to the south, the states of Sonora, for example, Sinaloa, and Chihuahua. So in one sense, Father Polzer came pretty close to getting that New World Archive, because those 1,200 reels of microfilm and other documentation, including over 8,000 books that make up the library of the Office of Ethnohistorical Research, really is an archive for researchers and our students who want to know more about the peoples and cultures, a very multicultural understanding of the Southwest. So that's one sort of one perspective. And it's Father Polzer, while he provided the intellectual inspiration for the foundation of DRSW here at the Arizona State Museum, it would not have taken off, it would not have become part and parcel of ASM's mission if it wasn't for the administrative and institutional support of Dr. Raymond Thompson, our former director. He also recognized that the mission of the Arizona State Museum was anthropology, had a much broader context to it, so he brought in the ethno-historical element to the Arizona State Museum. And I would just add one other thing about the national impact of DRSW and also Father Polzer. Even till today, when you pick up a U.S. history textbook, inevitably always starts with the 13 British colonies on the east coast of what we now call the United States. Father Polzer, at some intellectual and conceptual level, tried to combat that the history of the United States doesn't start with Plymouth Rock. It actually has a much deeper history that involves not England, it involves Spain. And of course, the Spanish presence dating to, well, at least since 1492 and going into the early 16th century. Over time, other colleagues who were part of the DRSW, now that we call it the Office of Ethnohistorical Research, began to say, well, it's not just the history of Spain that makes Southwest unique, it's also native peoples and the native voice. So what you've seen since Father Polzer retired in 1997, there was a shift then of not just emphasizing Spain, but bringing native peoples and indigenous peoples and their voices. So the kinds of scholarship that's produced in the DRSW, or the Office of Ethnohistorical Research, is not just Spanish-centric. It also includes that very important indigenous perspective.